spending no time on the weekend. And we don't talk barely even anymore. We don't even kiss as a reason. I'm pretty sure it's safe to assume you cheated on me.
Somebody Does is a song about being in a relationship with somebody that does not appreciate you and finally getting to that point where you're fed up and telling them, you know what, you don't got to come home. You don't got to give me flowers. You don't got to do none of that. You don't have to love me, because trust and believe, somebody does. Somebody out there does. There's somebody out there that's going to treat me the way that you should be treating me. And when I find that person, you're going to be sick to your stomach.
A lot of times we try to hold on to people who, you know, don't want us anymore or don't appreciate us, or it's just, you know, they would be fine without us. So, you know, that's what it is. It's just, you know, simple. If this particular person that you want doesn't want you, somebody out there does. It was nice meeting Neo, because I kind of idolized him growing up too.
She gave me a little bit of oh my God, you're Neo, a little bit of that. But only a little bit, like not even enough for me to be like, all right, is she really a fan, or did somebody tell her before she came in here that she should act like she know me?
I felt starstruck, and I felt a little embarrassed, because I don't do profanity in my music, and there were some words in there, not hard, but just some words in there and some lines in there we had to change. One of the songs is Somebody Does, and I think one of the lines said something like, I've been creeping for the last 2 weeks. It was kind of like an in-your-face song. I was like, I don't want to be a cheater. He was like, what? I said, I don't want to be a cheater. I don't want to cheat. I've been creeping for the last... He was like, wow, okay. So he takes the pencil and paper, and he changes it.
I'm pretty sure it's safe to assume you cheated on me. Somebody else been checking on me for the last 2 weeks.
And I was like, I'm so sorry.
When she came in and she heard the song, she was like, I love it except for this part right here. And that's the thing about me. Like, I'm not the songwriter that says, do it the way I gave it to you, or let me keep it. I'm not that dude. I want you to take it and make it you, make it yours, because at the end of the day, it's going to be your voice on it, not mine. You got to stand on stage in front of however many people and convince them of this song, not me. So if there's a line that needs to be changed here, I got no problem with that. And I actually was proud of the fact that she was actually brave enough to tell me, you know, I love this, but this right here is not me. Like, that means, that showed me right there that she's very, very self-aware. And that she's got some confidence in her, which two things that are gonna carry her very far.
Beep beep, there's your Uber. I really, really don't think that I was asking too much. But everything that you wouldn't do, believe me, he does.
Hey you guys, so everyone who followed me from American Idol to now we in Motown, and we getting ready to put out my new album, Already. I just want to say I thank you for your support. I thank you for your love. I thank you for your patience, because it did take a long time. But now we're here. So I can't wait for you guys to hear it. I really hope that it touches your soul the way it's touched mine. I really hope that you get a bit of insight into my heart and my mind. And you've been on this journey with me thus far, and so, you know, I can't wait for you guys to hear it and to be blessed by it. So go out, get the album, purchase it, and let me know what you think.